imagine someone says to you, you know what show you should watch? TV show X. And you reply, you know what? I watched the first couple episodes and I didn't care for it. And then they get a sly look on their face and say, yes, but what kind of TV did you watch them on? Now, freeze your imagination right there. Zoom in on the look on your face when they said that. That suddenly perplexed look of incomprehension where you're thinking to yourself, sure, different types of TVs do affect the shows that you're watching, but not in such a way that a show you don't like is going to turn into one that you do like on a different TV. Swim in that feeling for just a second. And now you know how I feel every time a would-be apologist says, yes, but what translation did you read? I mean, look, I get that there will be differences. Most of them are going to be subtle, but some of them will matter, right? Like there's a genuine difference between the strong hand of God and the mighty fist of God. But unless you're arguing that bad translations of your holy book add in knots where they don't belong and leave them out where they do, my issue with your book is a hell of a lot deeper than poor choice of adjective can ameliorate. Is there a translation of the Bible where Jesus doesn't cure mental illness by putting the demons in pigs and then massacring them? Is there a translation without talking animals? Is there a translation where one isn't encouraged to beat their children or instructed on how to beat their slaves? No? Then what does it fucking matter which translation I read? And look, we anticipated this bullshit. Right, way back when this show first started, we decided we were going to do a book-by-book breakdown of the Bible. Heath, Lucinda, and I all read different translations. Heath read the King James, Lucinda read the NIV, and I chose my Bible with a ruler and wound up with the New Oxford Annotated, a Bible with more footnotes and explanatory essays than Bible. And by the way, most of those footnotes were about alternate translations. Right. So when we went to break down the various books of the Bible, we actually talked about the differences in our three versions, but we didn't talk about them very much because they weren't very consequential. When we lined our notes up at the end of the week, lo and behold, turns out we were all still reading the same book. Now, don't get me wrong. I understand why the defenders of faith are so quick to toss out this meaningless defense. Most of the best arguments in favor of holy books are context dodges. Right? And those all fall apart when you're arguing with somebody who's actually read your book. See, the way this is supposed to go is that I say, well, you know, the Bible isn't a good moral guide because it says X. And then they say, well, have you ever actually read the Bible? To which I'm supposed to stammer a bit and sheepishly admit that, no, I didn't work my way through all of these endless pages of genealogies and repetitious Hebrew pseudo-history to discover the exact context of the it's okay to beat your slaves if they wake up passage. And already that's a pretty weak fucking argument. Just like people who fall into that trap can jujitsu it real quick by asking them any context in which that passage wouldn't be grossly immoral. But it's even worse for them when you say, yes, I actually have read the Bible because A, they can't use their go-to context argument. And B, more often than not, that just makes the one of us who's actually read it cover to cover. By and large, I find myself dealing with apologists who haven't read the Bible, but rather people who have been told by somebody that did read it that the passages they were queasy about sound better in context. But on the rare occasion that I encounter somebody who's actually taken the time to read their holy book too, the next bullet out of their gun is always the translation question. And if you say, oh, I read the KJV, they'll scoff and they'll sigh and they'll act as though that explains everything. They'll laugh off your naive ignorance at going with such an outdated version of God's immutable word and assure you that you just need to reread 1,100 more pages of bullshit. Then you'll see why you had the Bible so wrong. And consider what a bullshit dodge this really is. Right, because it's not like their hopes is that you actually will go out and read another translation and then come back to them. Right. Their hope is that you'll agree to pretend that you don't share enough common facts to have a rational argument. They're not trying to elucidate. They're trying to eliminate. They don't want to have to defend their holy book. So they're trying to manufacture a situation where we both throw up our hands and say, well, we lack sufficient data to pursue this line of debate. Let's argue from some different angle where atheism doesn't have so much of a head start. And anytime you encounter that strategy, you should raise an eyebrow. You know, don't get me wrong. There are good reasons to make sure everybody's working from the same fact set. So if the goal here is to have an agreed upon translation to pull quotes from, I guess maybe there could be some integrity in that. But if the goal is otherwise, it's just to muddy the water enough so that no mutual fact set can exist. You're just not dealing with somebody who's wrong here. You're dealing with somebody who knows they're wrong. right? This is somebody who has already concluded that their position can't stand up to logical scrutiny, and they're just trying not to have to say that loud enough for themselves to hear it.